Hi, this is Henk Akkermans, and this is Supply Chain Dynamics Chapter 1, SysDea Gameplay 3, Oscillation. And let's talk about oscillation. What we see in this model is oscillation. It should be so simple. We have 500 of work coming in. We need 500 of work to be done. Our capacity initially is higher than that, which is only nice, you would assume, 1,000. But it's too much, so we want to bring the amount of capacity lower to until it's also 500, and we have these variables to do that for us and these equations. But what you see in the model is that at the moment that capacity is really at 500, it continues to decline a little bit, it overshoots. Immediately that means that the amount of work starts to grow again, because less than 500 is going out while more than 500 is coming in. And so by the time that capacity is at this lower level and starts to go back up again, capacity is again up. So from lower to higher and higher and lower. That's oscillation. And how can we get rid of it? It has perhaps to do a little bit with the delay. So let's see if we can change some of the delays. We have two delays in this model. There's a target lead time here and the capacity change delay here. For the purpose of comparison, let's see if we can keep these values and then make some difference of changes up here. The way to do that in SysDea, that's all nicely explained in the SysDea tutorial, is with Ctrl C, Ctrl V, put these variables, put these values in here, and the same up here also, Ctrl C, Ctrl V. See, I already did that there. The nice thing is if we now change the target lead time, for instance, to 1, then we see both the current and the future variables. So that's nice. See, if we make it 4, if we make it 0.5, 0.5, all these different values have possibilities there.